Elite Facts presents
9 nuclear disasters that shook the world.
9.
Palomar's B-52 crash. On January 17, 1966, an American B-52 bomber embarked on a mission from Seymour Johnson Air Force Base, North Carolina. The aircraft was carrying 4 Type B-28 hydrogen bombs. The mission was part of the Cold War U.S. Operation Chrome Dome. The plane was scheduled to travel east across the Atlantic Ocean and Mediterranean Sea towards the European borders of the Soviet Union. The flight time required 2 mid-air refueling sessions over Spain. During the second aerial refueling, the B-52 bomber contracted the KC-135 tanker while flying at 31,000 feet, or 9,450 meters. The nozzle of the refueling boom hit the top of the B-52 fuselage, breaking the longeron and snapping off the left wing. The KC-135 was completely destroyed when its fuel load ignited, killing all 4 crew members. The B-52 broke apart, killing 3 of the 7 crew members aboard. The aircraft and the nuclear weapons crashed to earth near the fishing village of Palomares, part of the Cuervos del Almanzoro municipality in the Almeria province of Andalusia, Spain. The conventional explosives in 2 of the nuclear bombs detonated upon impact, dispersing plutonium over nearby farms, residential areas, and woods. It was estimated that 2 square kilometers of land was severely contaminated by radioactive plutonium. Of the 4 B-28 hydrogen bombs, 3 were found on land near the small fishing village of Palomares. The 4th bomb fell into the Mediterranean Sea and was recovered intact after a 2.5 months-long search. It was located at a depth of 2,900 feet, or 880 meters. To diffuse public alarm about the contamination, the Spanish Minister of Information and Tourism, Manuel Fraga, and the U.S. Ambassador, Angier Biddle Duke, swam on nearby beaches in front of press. The U.S. Ambassador first swam at Mojicar, and then the pair swam at the Quitapalejos beach in Palomares. 4 days after the accident, the Spanish government announced that a NATO aircraft could no longer be permitted to fly over Spanish territory, either to or from Gibraltar. On January 25, 1966, the U.S. announced that it would no longer fly over Spain with nuclear weapons, and on the 29th, the Spanish government formally banned U.S. flights over its territory that carried such weapons. Millions of dollars were spent on the radioactive cleanup. However, 45 years after the accident, radioactive material remains. In 2004, a study revealed that there was still significant amounts of contamination present in certain areas, and the Spanish government subsequently expropriated some plots of land, which would have otherwise been slated for agriculture or housing. In early October of 2006, the Spanish and United States governments agreed to decontaminate the remaining areas. Since the study began, reports have indicated that snails and other wildlife have been observed with unusual levels of radioactivity. 2 years after the Palomares nuclear disaster, another B-52 bomber involved with Operation Chrome Dome crashed. The plane was also carrying a load of 4 hydrogen bombs. The nuclear accident became known as the 1968 Thule Air Base B-52 nuclear crash. During the incident, a fire broke out in the navigator's compartment of a U.S. B-52 near Thule Air Base in Greenland. The plane crashed 7 miles, or 11 kilometers, from the air base, rupturing its nuclear payload of 4 hydrogen bombs. The nuclear weapons landed in North Star Bay, Greenland, resulting in widespread radioactive contamination. The incident caused outrage and protests in Denmark, as Greenland is a Danish possession. After the accident, the United States and Denmark launched an intensive cleanup and recovery operation, although the decontamination effort was complicated by Greenland's harsh weather. Tons of contaminated ice and debris were shipped and buried in the U.S. One of the nuclear weapons remains lost to this day. The U.S. Project Chrome Dome was discontinued immediately after the incident. This nuclear accident directly led to more stable nuclear warhead development in the United States.
8.
Windscale fire. In 1946, the Second World War ended and the United States government passed legislation that removed all nuclear weapons programs in other countries. Many British scientists participated in the Manhattan Project, and the British government did not want to be left behind in the nuclear arms race, so they created a nuclear weapons program. Nuclear reactors were constructed near the tiny village of Seascale, Cumberland, and were known as Windscale Pile 1 and Windscale Pile 2. The facilities produced plutonium for the first British atom bomb. After the successful testing of the British nuclear weapon, the U.S. designed and exploded a hydrogen bomb, which requires tritium. Britain did not have any facility to produce tritium and decided to use the Windscale piles. Higher temperatures are required to produce tritium. The decision was made to reduce the size of the nuclear cooling fans used at the site. This enabled the production of tritium, but it also created three separate hotspots in Pile 1. The precise cause of the accident is not clear, but on October 10, 1957, parts of the nuclear reactor overheated and a fire started in the Windscale Pile 1. The resulting fire burned for days, damaging a significant portion of the reactor core. The nuclear fire released radioactive gases into the surrounding countryside, primarily in the form of iodine-131. It was estimated that 20,000 curies of iodine-131 and around 1,000 curies of caesium-137 were released. However, like any nuclear accident, claims have been made that the contamination was much more severe. No people were evacuated from the surrounding area, but there was a concern that milk might be dangerously contaminated. Milk distribution was banned in a 200 square mile or 520 kilometer area around the reactor for a month. Thousands of gallons of contaminated milk were dumped into the Irish Sea. Subsequent investigations have suggested that the official records may have been altered in an attempt to cover up the possibility that during the radiation leak, the wind was blowing out to sea, significantly increasing the contamination dose to Ireland and the Isle of Man. The direct damage to the surrounding area is unclear, and a 1987 report by the National Radiological Protection Board predicted the accident would cause as many as 33 long-term cancer deaths. Windscale Pile 1 was unsalvageable, and after the removal of some damaged fuel cell rods, it was left alone. In 2008, the British government announced that it would continue decontaminating the site. No air-cooled reactors have been built since the Windscale fire disaster. Modern technology uses water as a cooling agent. The Windscale fire was considered the world's worst reactor accident until the Three Mile Island incident of 1979. The Three Mile Island nuclear disaster was a partial core meltdown in Unit 2 at the Three Mile Island Nuclear Generating Station in Dauphin County, Pennsylvania. However, the details of the Soviet Kyshtym nuclear disaster that occurred on September 29, 1957 was not made public for many years.
7.
Soviet submarine K-219. The K-219 submarine was a ballistic missile sub used by the Soviet Union during the Cold War. It carried 16 missiles equipped with an estimated 34 nuclear warheads. On October 3, 1986, the submarine was on patrol 680 miles, or 1,090 kilometers, northeast of Bermuda when the seal in one of the missile hatch covers failed. This allowed seawater to leak into the missile tube and react with residue from the missile's liquid fuel, producing nitric acid. The K-219 suffered a subsequent explosion and fire in the missile tube. The Soviet Navy claimed that the leak was caused by a collision with the submarine USS Augusta. However, the United States Navy has challenged the claim because the K-219 had previously experienced a similar problem, and one of the submarine's missile tubes was disabled and welded shut because of the accident. After the explosion occurred in Silo 6, the remains of the RSM-25 rocket and its two nuclear warheads were ejected into the sea. The vessel quickly surfaced to permit its twin nuclear reactors to be shut down. The submarine was then strapped to a Soviet freighter, and an attempt to tow the vessel was made. However, the flooding had reached a point beyond recovery, and the K-219 sank to the bottom of the Hatteras Abyssal Plain in 18,000 feet or 5,500 meters of water. The K-219's full arsenal of nuclear weapons and reactors went down with the vessel. In 1986, the Soviet hydrographic research ship Keldysh positioned itself over the wreck and reported that the submarine was sitting in the upright position on the bottom of the ocean. It had broken into sections, and it appeared that several missile silo hatches had been forced open, and the missiles, along with the nuclear warheads they contained, were gone. Soviet leader Mikhail Gorbachev privately communicated news of the disaster to U.S. President Ronald Reagan before publicly acknowledging the incident. The K-219 Soviet submarine nuclear accident was one of the most controversial events of the Cold War.
6.
Goldsboro B-52 crash. On January 24, 1961, an American B-52 bomber was on a 24-hour airborne alert mission over the Atlantic seaboard. The aircraft was carrying two Mark 39 nuclear weapons on board. During the mission, the B-52 was scheduled to meet with a tanker for mid-air refueling. While the plane was being refueled, the B-52 captain, Major W.S. Tulloch, was notified that his aircraft had a leak in its port wing fuel cell. The plane was directed to assume a holding pattern off the coast until the majority of fuel was used up. However, the captain soon reported that his plane had lost 37,000 pounds, or 17,000 kilograms, of fuel in 3 minutes. He was immediately ordered to land at Seymour Johnson Air Base, which is located in Goldsboro, North Carolina. As the plane descended to 10,000 feet, the pilots were no longer able to control the aircraft. The captain ordered the crew to eject, which they did at 9,000 feet, or 2,700 meters. The plane broke apart as it spiraled to the ground and the nuclear weapons were separated from the craft. The wreckage of the plane and its two nuclear warheads landed in a 2 square mile, or 5.2 kilometer, area of tobacco and cotton farmland near Goldsboro, North Carolina. 5 crewmen attempted to parachute to safety, but 3 died. One of the nuclear weapons discovered had become active. 5 of the 6 arming devices on the nuclear warhead activated, causing it to carry out many of the steps needed to arm itself, such as the charging of the firing capacitors and the deployment of a retardation parachute. The pilot's safe and arm switch was not activated, preventing detonation. However, nuclear material was released into the atmosphere. The second bomb plunged into a muddy field at around 700 miles per hour. It disintegrated and the bomb's tail was discovered about 20 feet or 6.1 meters under the earth. Some of the nuclear weapon was recovered, including the tritium bottle and all the plutonium. However, excavation was abandoned due to uncontrollable groundwater flooding. Most of the thermonuclear stage containing uranium was left in the North Carolina ground. It's estimated to lie around 55 feet or 17 meters below the earth. The Air Force purchased the land to prevent interference with the nuclear remnants.
5.
Guyana accident. September 13, 1987. More than 240 people were exposed to radiation when a junkyard dealer in Goiânia, Brazil, broke open an abandoned radiation therapy machine and removed a small, highly radioactive cake of cesium chloride. The accident occurred on September 13, 1987. The environment and surroundings were seriously contaminated. Many buildings had to be demolished. 4 people died in this accident. Many children got attracted to the bright blue of the radioactive material, touched it, and rubbed it on their skin, resulting in the contamination of several city blocks.
4.
Castle Bravo, March 1, 1954. Bikini Atoll, Micronesian Islands in the Pacific Ocean, was the site of more than 20 nuclear weapons tests between 1946 and 1958. Castle Bravo was the code name given to the first U.S. test of a dry fuel thermonuclear hydrogen bomb. The test was performed on March 1, 1954 at Bikini Atoll, Marshall Islands. When the weapon was detonated, an explosion took place, leaving a crater of 6,500 feet or 2,000 meters in diameter and 250 feet or 75 meters deep. Castle Bravo was the most powerful nuclear device ever detonated by the United States, with a yield of 15 megatons, which was far exceeding the expected yield of 4 to 6 megatons. This miscalculation led to the most severe accidental radiological contamination ever caused by the United States. In terms of TNT tonnage equivalents, Castle Bravo was about 1,200 times more powerful than the atomic bombs that were dropped on Hiroshima and Nagasaki during World War II. Moreover, the radiation cloud contaminated more than 7,000 square miles of the surrounding Pacific Ocean, including small islands like Rangarik, Rangalap, and Uterik. These islands were evacuated, but generations to come were affected. Natives have since suffered from birth defects. A Japanese fishing boat, Daigo Fukuru Maru, also came into contact with the nuclear fallout, causing illness to all crew members with 1 fatality. Fish, water, and land were seriously contaminated, making Castle Bravo one of the worst nuclear accidents.
3.
Chalk River nuclear accident, 1952. Chalk River Laboratory, CRL, is a site of major research and development to support and advance nuclear technology, in particular CANDU reactor technology. On December 12, 1952, a reactor shutoff rod failure combined with several operator errors led to a major power excursion of more than double the reactor's rated output at AECL's NRX reactor. INES rated the incident at level 5. A series of hydrogen gas explosions hurled the 4-ton gas holder dome 4 feet through the air, where it jammed in the superstructure. Thousands of curries of fission products were released into the atmosphere, and 1 million gallons of radioactively contaminated water had to be pumped out of the basement and disposed of in shallow trenches not far from the Ottawa River. The core of the NRX reactor could not be decontaminated. It had to be buried as radioactive waste. Young Jimmy Carter, later U.S. president, then a nuclear engineer in the U.S. Navy, was among the hundreds of Canadian and American servicemen who were ordered to participate in the NRX cleanup following the accident.
2.
Kyshtym, Russia, 1957. The Kyshtym nuclear disaster was a radiation contamination incident that occurred on September 29, 1957, at Mayak, a nuclear fuel reprocessing plant in the Soviet Union. It measured as a level 6 disaster on the INES, making it the third most serious nuclear disaster ever recorded, behind the Chernobyl disaster and Fukushima Daiichi disaster. The event occurred in the town of Oziorsk, a closed city built around the Mayak plant. Since Oziorsk, Mayak was not marked on maps, the disaster was named after Kyshtym, the nearest known town.
1.
Chernobyl, Ukraine, 1986. The Chernobyl nuclear disaster is widely considered to be the worst power plant accident in history and is one of only two classified as a level 7 event on the International Nuclear Event Scale, the other being the Fukushima Daiichi disaster in 2011. The battle to contain the contamination and avert a greater catastrophe ultimately involved over 500,000 workers and cost an estimated 18 billion rubles. The official Soviet casualty count of 31 deaths has been disputed, and long-term effects such as cancers and deformities are still being accounted for.
Don't forget to like us and subscribe for more Elite Facts.